Hello everyone, I'm back again. This is going to be a tag video, which I haven't done on my channel in forever. Have I ever? I don't even think I've ever done a tag video. But this is going to be a tag video. I was tagged by Sakura Sakyokuka-san to do this Asia Obsession tag. I know it's late. I'm so sorry. Kurete sumimasen deshita. I had computer problems, but I'm gonna do it for you. Now this tag is supposed to be for those of us who are loving Asian culture. If that's you, I also tag you to do this. Let's just get that out of the way now. If you love Asian culture, any part of Asia, any country from Asia, you do this tag too. All right, let's get started. First question is, what is your favorite drama? My favorite Japanese drama is Kamisama mo sukoshi dakke, which in English means, God, please give me more time. It's a really old drama, I think from the early 90s, but gets me going every single time. And my favorite Korean drama, this is pretty hard, but I'm probably going to say, I really recently, well not recently, but when I was in Korea, I really liked Empress Ki. And I really liked it because usually I feel like dramas have an ending that, oh, I know it's coming. But Empress Ki, I did not see the ending coming at all. So I really liked Empress Ki. The next question, what was the first drama you ever watched? For Japanese, I think the first drama I ever watched was Hana Yori Dango, Boys Over Flowers in English. And for Korean, I believe the first drama I ever watched was Dream High. Next question, what is your favorite movie? My favorite Japanese movie. Wow. Oh, I don't know. I'm not sure. Pause, let's skip that. My favorite Korean movie. Oh my god, this is hard. My gosh, who made up these questions? Okay, let's just skip this question. I'll come back. Next question is, what was the first movie you ever watched? The first Japanese movie I ever watched was actually in college. Well, if you don't count animes, because, you know, I used to watch all the Sailor Moon anime movies, all the Dragon Ball Z anime movies, all the Rurouni Kenshin anime movies, all the Tenchi Muyo anime movies, all the Pokemon movies, all the Digimon movies, all the Yu-Gi-Oh movies. So if you don't count those, then the first Japanese movie I ever watched was in my freshman year of college, and it was in my Japanese film appreciation class. And it was a movie on Obunaga? I forgot his name, but it was a historical figure. It was a historical movie, and it was my first Japanese film that I can remember watching that wasn't anime. Now, the first Korean movie I ever watched was, I think, called A Moment to Remember. I don't want to say A Walk to Remember. I think A Walk to Remember is that Mandy Moore American movie. I think it's called A Moment to Remember. That was the first Korean movie I ever watched. Favorite Asian singer, group, or band? For Japanese, I want to say that my favorite singers are probably Shimizu Shota and Nerdhead and Every now and then, I listen to Keri Pamyu Pamyu, but she's not my favorite. And for Korean, I like 21, of course. I like Sistar. I like Big Bang. I don't want to say I like just K-pop, but I bangs with K-pop. But I like a lot of rappers, Korean rappers too. But as far as like singers, I think I probably listen to the most 21, Big Bang, and Sistar. Favorite Asian music video. For Korean, I think I really like the music video for I Got a Boy. Now hear me out. That music video had a lot of, I call it wannabeism, but it was really colorful. It had a lot of different scenes. The overall quality of the video was good. Now, if I actually like the video itself, I don't know, because I felt like Girls' Generation was trying so hard, but that's a whole nother story. So I really like I Got a Boy because of the visual aspect of it. And for Japanese videos, if I'm sticking along the lines of visual aspects, anything Keri Pamyu 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 does is ridiculously good. Her animation, her she's like, they call her like the Japanese Lady Gaga. She makes the most eye-catching, most stand-out-ish videos that I've ever seen coming from Japan. So she produces pretty good videos. Which Asian countries have you been to and or want to go to? I have lived in Japan and Korea, and I went to China. Now where I want to go is Taiwan, Thailand, and Cambodia. Those are the places that I want to go to next. Favorite anime or manga? I'm an OG, so I've been down with the classics, the original animes and mangas, and I think my favorite all-time favorite, it has to be Sailor Moon. I don't care what anybody says, Sailor Moon is the best ever thing that ever happened. And then if you want to say something more recent, it's not recent, but I still felt like it was very emotional and very impactful, was this anime called, it had a really long title, but I just remember Anohana was the short version of it, the flower that day, like 11 episodes or 12 episodes, boom, impact, you feel, you cry, everything. There's so many feels in that anime. And maybe manga, I really like Fushigi Yugi, and I like Attack on Titan, Shingeki no Kyojin. I like the anime, but I kind of like the manga more. Favorite Asian food? Oh, this is gonna be hard because I love Korean and Japanese food. My favorite Japanese food is nikujaga. Probably nikujaga. I eat it the most if I can get it. I love it, nikujaga, hands down. And my favorite Korean food is not just one. It can't be, but it's doenjang jjigae, samgyetang, galbi, any meat dish, any barbecue dish, and everything. But probably those are my top three Korean dishes. Kimchi, of course, but that's not a meal is all. Kimchi goes with anything. Jjayuk bokkeumbap, which is like spicy pork and rice. I love it. If you can find a place, you probably have to go to Koreatown because it's not going to be in a traditional Korean restaurant. But if you can find a place that offers jjayuk bokkeumbap and samgyetang, try it. How did my obsession start? Now, I really don't like this word, but obsession, because it's not a very nice word, but I want to say my liking of Asian culture, of course, started when I was young, watching animes, as everybody did growing up in America. You were practically bombarded with anime at all points of view if you watched Toonami or if you watched CW, which used to be WB50. So anytime you watch like kids shows, you're watching Japanese cartoons. But mine really started when my father told me that, well, he asked me a question. He asked me, what are the things that I like the most in my house, or what are the things that I feel I need the most? And I think 5 out of the 8 products were Japanese products. And he just really pushed me towards like all these great things come out of the Asian market, specifically Japan. It's a lot of importing and exporting going back and forth between America and Japan. So he really pushed me in that direction of wanting to learn more about Japan. But of course, I was started on with Toonami, of course. But yeah, that's kind of where the Japanese thing started. And for the Korean thing, I feel like I never really paid much attention to Korea when I was learning about Japan. It was kind of always just like a small part of Japanese history, even though it's a large part of it, but you're not really going to learn about it from a Japanese standpoint that it's a large part. But I want to say my interest in Korea started more when I realized that all three of the countries, China and Japan and Korea, work with each other and all have this intertwined history. And I started wanting to learn more about it. And then watching like dramas kind of got me looking at it like, man, Korea produces really interesting stuff, but they don't really get any attention. But this is way before the drama hype that is now in America came to be. This was probably like in 2008 or 2007 when I first listened to Big Bang, which was 2008. That was when I was like, okay, all right, I'm kind of feeling Korean music. Big Bang was kind of like a Korean version of B2K. That's what I always said. But that's how it started. And then it just got pushed forward when I started learning deeper about the economic structure and the political structure of Japan. And that's when I started learning about Korea on the side. And then, of course, as you know, I want to live in Korea. So now living in Korea brought me more awareness of Korea as a whole. And now I really wish I would have started earlier, but now I'm super interested in Korea, like all aspects of Korea, especially history. How has your obsession influenced your life? Well, like I said, I don't like this word obsession, but as you all know, if you watch my channel, it is part of my major. It is my focus of my major. It is the language choice that I chose to study, and it's the food I prefer to eat. It's affected a lot of my life, honestly. Sometimes I go to a Korean church and I listen to service because I was used to listening to service in Korea, or sometimes interpret for them. And a lot of my friends are Korean, Japanese, and Chinese, and it's played a huge role in my life as far as the person I've become after I started studying language and after I started being a host family and volunteering for Japanese exchange students. I think you remember, if you look at my channel 2 years back, there was a video with me and a girl, my friend, she's like my sister, my best friend, Chiyo Chang, and we did this video on studying abroad. That's when I first started becoming like a host family. And so it really opened my eyes, and it really allowed me to open the eyes of my other family members who are really, really traditional. And it just made myself a better person. I would like to believe that it made me more culturally aware of other people and more aware that I'm just not the only person, and America is not the only country, and you just have to get out that bubble. So it really influenced my life, and I want to say I changed for the better. At least I hope I changed for the better. I think I changed for the better. Are you interested in any Asian languages? Is the last question, and I think I just kind of answered it, but yes, speaking Japanese and speaking Korean, and would like to get deeper into Korean, and I want to start on introductory level Chinese if I can, because I hope to work with all three countries. So that's it for this video. Thank you so much, Sakyokuka-san, for tagging me in this video. It's the first time that I've done something that I've been tagged in, because I think I'm kind of like a recluse on YouTube. But anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to watch my previous video and stay tuned for the next video. Subscribe to my channel, Miss Brahane, up here. And don't forget, sharing is caring. Share this video if you liked it, please. Talk to me on social media, all platforms, Miss Brahane, and I will talk back. And I will see you guys in the next video. All right, bye bye. Mata ne. 안녕 가세요. Bye bye.